And joining us now for more perspective on this tragic case is True TV legal correspondent Jean Casares. Jean, good morning.
Good morning.
The boys have been arrested on suspicion of sexual battery. What's next in this case?
Well, these are the preliminary arresting charges, and they're being held at a juvenile facility. The three of them are 16 years old, so they're minors. So it creates a major issue here. Should they be tried as adults? Should they be tried as juveniles? The charges could be different. Ultimately, it's in the prosecutor's hands now.
And that's the big question. They've been arrested on sexual battery charges, but clearly there's a lot more involved here. So could there be more charges, especially when it comes to sending out this video, posting it on the internet?
You know, this is becoming a trend, and it's very, very scary. I mean, the Steubenville rape case, we just did that several weeks ago, and now we see something that just seems to mirror that. In this particular case, though, she died. She committed suicide. So a lot of people are going to wonder, should they be charged with causing her death? That has never been done before. Remember the Tyler Clemente case, Rutgers University?
Yep.
He jumped off the George Washington Bridge. There was talk, it was believed, that he would, that Darun Ravi, who set up this webcam to record the most intimate moments of Tyler Clemente, that he would be charged with causing the death. But we have manner of death, which is homicide, death at the hands of another, suicide, taking your own life.
And so you think that link is unlikely to be made here?
I think it's unlikely. It's too difficult, I think, to find beyond a reasonable doubt that what these young men allegedly did to her actually caused her death, even though it was days later. Suicide is something that can be very deep-rooted with
many
causes.
There may be other factors that we don't even know about.
Yes, but these are going to be serious charges, and they'll impact these young boys' lives forever if convicted.
Mm-hmm. You know that every parent out there is thinking, my goodness, what if this were my child? Are there lessons we can take from this?
Oh, I think there's so many lessons, so many, many lessons. Of course, that's not the legal area, but that is really parental responsibility. This young girl, 15 years old, went over to a home. Did her parents know she was going? Did they know that alcohol would be free-flowing? Because, once again, she didn't remember anything.
Right.
And she had to look at emails and texts, and there is a photo. We don't know what it shows, but she saw that photo. And then she wrote in Facebook, my life is over. And she committed suicide shortly after that.
Jean, is the legal system equipped to handle this kind of stuff now? I mean, we haven't seen this before.
No, I think technology has gone so fast and furious, and young people having that technology and making these poor choices, criminal choices in many respects. So I think legislatures are going to have to look at laws and maybe have brand new laws to find justice in a situation like this.
Jean Casares, thanks so much.
Thank you.